Kuzampola, Namaste, good morning to all respected online viewers. Long live their majesties, long live our leaders, and long live our friendship. Welcome to this online yoga and Ayurveda workshops, Embassy of India, Thimphu, ICCR's Nehru Wangchuk Culture Center, yoga teacher. I'm KVSSN Murthy here. My true prayers to the Almighty to see all the best things to their majesties and the whole Bhutan also. So coming recitation also actually from Hatha Yoga Pradipika, 3rd chapter, 30th hymn. It is saying that importance of the internal practices called bandhas and mudras. So especially we have three mudras called Mahabandha, Mahaveda, Mahamudra, Mahabandha, Mahaveda. So in a row, we can choose as per this teacher's instructions or Guruji's instructions. So some people may start from the Mahaveda, some people may start from Mahamudra, some people may start from Mahabandha also. But important thing is concentration at the eyebrow center while doing these practices, or aware of the dharana while doing these practices are more important. It is saying that etat trayam mahaguhyam, etat trayam mahaguhyam jara mrityu vinasanam vahini uriddhikaram chaiva animadi astaguna siddhi pradayakam. So here it is saying that etatra means these three are very important practices. Especially here yoga, the greatest yoga Guruji Swatma Ramal mentioned that specifies about these three practices, Mahabandha, Mahamudra, Mahaveda, which destroys the geriatric problems and old age, also which destroys the fear of death and extends the healthy longevity. And it increases the digestive fire, immunity, metabolic activity and everything. So with these only three practices, anyone can be healthy with a good longevity. But the way how we are doing, the approach is very important with the food disciplines, with the remaining life disciplines. And coming to the COVID protocols, coming to the simple practices, please always try to follow safe physical distancing and do not touch any surfaces when you are going outside, and always carry sanitizer to clean the arms and hands, and wear masks and ear caps or facial covers when you are coming back to the home. Thoroughly wash them, and respiratory hygiene, like installing nostril drops called Anutaila or Shadbindu Taila into the nostrils morning and evening. Also, it will balance the phlegm related errors. And throat hygiene, for the throat hygiene, you can go for throat gargling by adding Estimadu powder or Tripala powder, or you can add simple salt water. And as well as oil pulling or mouth pulling, you can use sesame oil or mustard oil or coconut oil for oil pulling, or you can use plain water also for water pulling for the mouth's health. And steam inhalation in a day at least 3 to 4 times may recommend it. It's depend on the environment and your house conditions. And here in the steam inhalation, you can use eucalyptus oil or ajwain seed oil also, or you can take plain inhalation, steam inhalations. And 6 to 8 hours sleep required, 1 more hour required if you are more active in your remaining efforts. And cloves powder and honey preparation also good to control the excess phlegm, especially dry cough. And especially please remember, when you have sickness, when you are ill, please don't opt self-medication, especially in these days. If you are really suffering from the dry coughs or colds, so immediately you can choose good doctor to take advice. And vitamin A diet, vitamin D diet and zinc-based diets, very important. Those are abundantly available in local fresh organic vegetables and fruits and mushrooms and milk products. Please have them in your meals. So do not blindly depend on the only one meal, the carbohydrates. Do not blindly depend on the animal fats. Somewhat it may give some indigestion and further complications. And in your home, I think everyone's home, we have this simple home natural remedy is called turmeric, garlic, ginger, ajwain seeds, as well as ajwain oil and jaljeera powder, and cumin, cinnamon, and coriander leaves or coriander powder, and ilachi, rock salt, and hing, pepper, and honey, and plus golden milk, milk and turmeric preparation, golden milk and kada chai preparation with local organic materials. and local Shilajit and local Cordyceps and Chyawanprash. These are very simple items to boost up the immunity. So today also we have our simple very simple practice for the skin disorder called skin flaps or skin tags. So as we know that this skin tags or skin flaps is because of HPV, human papilloma virus also. But it's because of hygiene and because of heredity also it may come. In the Ayurveda, we have very simple solutions called Vatare Gugulu or Guruchi or Ashwagandha or Estimadu preparations or even Tripala also very good for the skin, and Shariva, Amruta, Vallataka, Lehya and Manjista. And these are very simple Ayurvedic preparations as well as applications also, external applications and as well as foods also. And especially Ayurveda way of processed zinc also very important to keep us healthy against these viral infections and bacterial infections. But the way how we are using also very important. So today we have very simple practices for the same skin tags. Now like a regular candle. Regular candle dust and calcium. Candle dust and calcium, take 10 grams and 10 grams, properly mix and grind it and mix with a paste and apply on that skin called external application on the especially skin tags or external growths on the skin. So it will take 21 days to you will get rid of this skin tags. Second practice is very simple to smoothen the skin called banana peel. So take that banana and peel out, and with that peel rub that affected area like at least 4 to 5 times a day. Then immediately after rubbing, immediately attach a plaster or sticker on that for at least 15 minutes time. So especially do not expose towards the rough conditions of the weather and do not expose to the strong sun after applying this kind of methods. So next preparation is, so you can take latex or milk-like substance from the ficus species. You can take peepal tree, religiosa, or you can take udambara tree, or you can take rubber tree. So all these are somewhat related to ficus species. So you can take extract from the ficus, that milk or latex also very useful in making the skin healthy. So especially after applying that that milk or that latex on the specially affected area, immediately keep a bandage or keep a plaster on that affected area. So please remember, do not touch those milk, don't touch your ears and do not come into the contact with that milk and ice, because it may somewhat create danger also to the eyes. So next one is very simple application called potato rubbing. So you can take potato and cut it half, and with that potato, so just rub on the skin. So somewhat it will give smoothen on the skin peripheral areas. Then after rubbing with the potato, again please place a bandage or a tape, and do not expose to the rough weather. So this is common instructions. But if these are beyond your methods or beyond our home remedies, please try to choose a doctor and do not use rough items or any other sharp items to cut or to insert inside around that affected area. So it will cause somewhat inflammation and septic. So tomorrow when we are meeting here at the same place for the same cause, so we will see still more applications, home remedies for the same skin tags and skin flaps. Let's join to the yoga class now. And sun salutation is our regular practice with the mantra chanting and the sloka chanting. So according to your traditional belief, you can follow with the chanting of mantra, or you can just choose only physical exercises. Okay, long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Then very slowly wide the arms and lift your arms up above to the head called Kailasha Mudra, and from there to bring that palms towards the chest called Anahata Pranamasam. And take a long, slow, deep inhalation and exhalation. Om Hiranmayena Patrena Satyasyapi Hitam Mukham Tatvam Pushan Apavrunu Satya Dharmaya Drushtaye. Om Hram Hrim Hrum Haim Haum Raha
मित्र रवि सूर्य भानु गग पूष्ण हिरण्य गर्भ मरीच आदित्य सवित्र अर्क भास्कराय नमः। स्ट्रेच योर बोथ आर्म्स फॉरवर्ड एंड लिफ्ट योर बोथ द आर्म्स अप। हस्त उत्तान आसन, कंप्लीटली कीप योर हैंड्स बिहाइंड द हेड, वंस पुल अप and from there slightly put a back bend or according to your flexibility you can bend more, called Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Then again keep your body straight, once pull up, very slowly push your hips back and bend the body forward, called Padahastasana. But when you have lower back issues or neck issues, or if you have blood pressure issues or heart ailments, better to choose easiest way or avoid the practices. Completely bend the body forward and here Padahastasana 2, Aswa Sanchalanasan. Here avoid crunching or hunching the back. Push your body forward, lift your chin up throughout the practice. Keep slant your position like a horse rider. And few seconds stay now. 1, 2 and then come back. Here back leg straight on the toes. And join your forward leg to back leg, called Santulanasan or Dandasan. Again few seconds stay here. And tight your gut muscles and tight your abdomen, lower abdomen. Then after that, very slowly push your body down towards the floor, called Ashtanga Namaskarasana or Sa Ashtanga Namaskarasana. Completely press the body down. Then very slowly push your body forward and lift the body like a sea wave, and called Cobra Poster or Bhujangasana. Throughout the practice, do not hang your body in between the shoulders. Against the shoulders, keep push the body up, lift the chin up and stay up. And back leg straight on the toes, back leg knee up and push your body inside, called Mountain Triangular Posture or Parvatasana. Again, right leg is your forward leg, called Aswa Sanchalanasana or Horse Riding Posture. This posture may not suitable to the people who are having knee issues or ankle issues or somewhat hip issues. Alright, back leg straight on the toes and back leg knee up against the gravity, and slowly join your back leg to forward leg, called Padahastasana. Again, very slowly lift your both the arms and body, Hasta Uttanasana or Sarir Uttanasana. Completely push yourself up. And from there, slightly put a back bend, called Ardha Chandrasana or Ardha Chakrasana. Then again, slowly keep the body straight. Pranamasana above to the head. And very slowly bring your pranamasana down at your chest level, called Anahata Pranamasana. And lift your arms up, inhalation. And very slowly exhalation, wide your both hands and very slowly keep them down towards the thighs. Then few seconds settle yourself for healthy breath. Just long, deep, slow inhalation, exhalation. Alright, now today's our exercise. Let's start somewhat pigeon posture variations and pigeon postures. Okay, now try to sit properly on any convenient surface. So here first, check your condition, check your legs, check your dress, and few seconds rest your hips and rest your knees by moving them on right side, left side, or you can do butterfly movement also to free the hip joints and the knees. Few seconds movement of the knees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, right, 10, come back here. Before adding pigeon series to our practices, so it is always better to do some of the pre-positions for the pigeon posture. One is cobbler posture. So push your body forward and keep pull your heels towards the perineal region. So with your two hands, give a slight press towards the floor on the knees, or you can keep your elbows straight also according to your convenience. Few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, relaxation, sit up, then slowly come straight. Now fold the knees and few seconds rest. Long, slow inhalations and exhalations. Right, keep your body straight. And now here, wide your both the legs, especially left leg, properly wide. Then after that, completely keep that leg stretched back. Then here, fold your forward leg inside and try to adjust your both the hands. And here, right, first coming to the variation one, try to completely stretch your arms forward and try to fold the abdomen on the thigh and press your abdomen muscle with your forward leg, knee, and few seconds stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then very slowly come back. Keep your both the hands drag back, lift your chin up. Once adjust the body, then here try to put your hands on the palms on the floor, or you can close your fingers, you can be on the knuckles to push your body more, or still if you want more pressing or more pushing, you can keep your hands on the knee also to press the body more. Once lift your chin up, and for, especially these postures, I'm requesting my technician to come on my right side or left side. Okay, now here lift your one hand completely up for a straight one, or you can put a slightly back bend also. And 1, 2, 3, and 4, and slowly come back, relaxation. So during your practices, if you got like cramps or any other strains, immediately relax and after that resume the class. Now after that, alternate arm completely up and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then very slowly come back. Then once relax your hips, after that lift your two hands up. You can slightly lift your arms in pranamasana, or according to your convenience, you can catch your head also by interlocking your fingers. Give a maximum press back and stay as a posture. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then very slowly come back. Then here, relax. Then here, then few seconds relaxation. Then after that, fold your back leg. Then here also, once try to check the condition of the leg and condition whether you can do or not. Press towards the abdomen or hips. Again, few seconds relaxation. Then once you will be able to do that, then after that, totally fold your leg and put your, that concern, left elbow at your toes to raise your forearm. And keep lift your alternate arm and few seconds catch the toe if possible. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then very slowly come back, relaxation. Then one quick relaxation in this posture or in any convenient posture. Again, few seconds rest. Still, I will do some more variations in the same pigeon stance, and few seconds relax your hips and relax your legs. Right, for the same cause, again, open your left leg properly, then keep adjust your hips and keep adjust your dress, then fold your left leg. So here once try to catch your right leg ankle also with the right hand. Already you catch your left leg, so that try to lift your two legs at a time and few seconds stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and very slowly come back. 5. And here also once give a relaxation by movement, hip movement or butterfly movement. 1, 2, 3, 4, and right, 5. Relaxation. Again, I'm doing the same leg stretching, left leg back stretch. Right here, you can fold your leg. Then if you are more convenient while turning your elbow, you can just turn your elbow, or you can catch your that concerned leg with your other hand. Again, few seconds stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then relaxation and slowly come back. Then leave your leg. Then very slowly keep open your leg and rest your two legs now. So this is a row of practices so that if the people wants to do in that same row, so you may not give more relaxation time also. But when you want to do one posture to other posture, you can give 15 seconds to 20 seconds in between the postures. Few seconds, relax your thighs, relax your legs. Then after that, open your two legs forward. Again, few seconds rest. So during this total workout, total pigeon series, one side and second side, so more chances of catching cramps around the thighs, around the hip region. So that take care of your good warm up. So that if you are in good warm up, then you will not suffer more. And opposite side, same thing. Keep wide your right leg to the right side. Then after that, fold your left leg. Then keep open your right leg back. Then I'm doing the same postures on other side. Then first important posture is to push your body completely forward and to press your abdomen on the thigh and put your head on the floor and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then very slowly keep open your hands back, then slowly push and lift your chin up. On the way, slightly move your hands back. So you can be on the knuckles by closing your fist, or you can put your two hands or one hand on the thighs to press your body more. Lift your head up, few seconds, stay like in a back bending and kind of throat stretching also. Few seconds stay now. 1, 2, and here, try to keep your body straight. Once relax from the posture. Then I'm doing same exercise, same posture with the other variation. All right, again, keep fold your left leg inside and right leg completely open back. Then try to adjust your two hands, put them on the floor or on the thigh. Then here, use remaining arm support to lift your one arm to bend back and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then very slowly come back, relaxation. And same thing here, opposite side hand, then very slowly keep lift your chin up and very slowly lift your alternate arm up, and as a posture stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then very slowly come back. Then once quick relaxation in butterfly movement or knee turns or hip movement turns, and few seconds relax your legs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then 6, come back. Again, come to the pre position. Again, fold your left leg inside and open your right leg backside. All right, this time keep like lift your two hands at a time up with the open hand variation or closed hand variation. Give a maximum stretch and stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then very slowly keep open the arms up and slowly release your arms, relaxation. So you can directly choose back leg fold, or you can create a small gap in between the posture to posture. Then I'm doing in a row, but so that fold your leg. Now here, keep press your leg towards the hip position. 1, then come strides. Again, 2, and come strides. Last count, completely press towards the hips here. You can put your right elbow at the right toe to keep your forearm straight, to keep your leg straight. And here, keep lift your alternate arm up. Then here, try to touch your already folded hand fingers, or you can directly bend the body more to catch your toes and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then very slowly, then come back, relaxation. So here, once have a quick break by movement of the knees in the butterfly movement or knee turns. So like in a row, we are doing nearly 12 to 14 postures, so that people may find as if I'm doing fast, but I'm not doing really fast. I'm doing a flow now. Okay, now coming to again, back leg, right leg stretch properly. Then here again, back leg fold for the next very good variation for the healthy knees and healthy legs. Right, fold your above leg. At the same time, catch your below leg ankle to press your legs. 1, then come back. Second last count, few seconds to stay now. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Relaxations, enough, come back. Again, few seconds rest. So doing fast is a different pattern. Doing flow is a different pattern. From posture to posture, we have to move quick. And now coming to the last exercise. So for this, the people, if you are not really able to turn your elbow out, you can choose cloth also for the same exercise. Then here I'm using a cloth. All right. Just fold your leg. Then try to keep turn your elbow. This cloth variation is very easy. Now hold the cloth. Now try to keep pull the leg towards the head and stay for a while. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Relaxation. Then slowly keep your leg back. Then very slowly stretch back and relax from the cloth and relax from the posture. Then soon after this, again try to care about the relaxation post stretches of the thighs and the knees. And relax your legs, relax your breath, relax your hip region and pelvic region. And very slowly stretch your both the legs and fold your legs, then towards your right side, towards your left side, just go for your knee turns for
still more relaxing at the hip level as well as at the joints of the knees and at the thighs. All right, and now come straight.
So before end up this physical exercise, we have last posture. As anyhow, till now,
almost this PGN series was with the back bends. Now we have to do only one forward bend. So that I prefer Vajrasana first. Fold your one leg and sit on the leg and just slant your body on the folded leg side to fold remaining leg under the hips and keep your position straight. Sashankasana or Mandukasana or Ashwini Mudrasana, or you can choose any simple forward bending. So Sashankasana itself called as the people who are doing the Sashankasana, like, they will get complexion in the face as well as they will be master on their own anger. Then here completely stretch your hands forward and try to put your head on the floor according to your convenience. And then very slowly lift your chin up. Again, very slowly keep moving your hands back and rest your arms, rest your legs. Once take a long, slow inhalations and exhalations. But during your self-practice time, in the total PGN series, you can choose only one posture in a day, or you can choose in a row of activities, row of practices, or you can choose flow yoga also. Basically, what I'm trying to tell is, like, yoga can be applicable in a slow variation, slow pace, as well as medium pace, as well as fast variations also. But the way how we are doing also important, because of yoga practices, like don't fall sick. All right, coming to the pranayam practices here. So today also I'm now doing my lotus posture, but participants may sit in any convenient, comfortable posture on any convenient surface. Then here lotus or half lotus or Vajrasana or simple cross leg posture, or you can sit on the chair or bed also. Okay, long, slow, deep inhalations and exhalations. And coming to mantra chanting and sloka chanting before adding the pranayam into our practices. So this, in other words, this mantra chanting meaning is, the purpose of the yoga or pranayam is not only for the physical health or material wealth. So we have a different definite goal called spiritual upliftment. Like, we have to be care about this body through postures, we have to be care about the mind through meditations, and we have to be care about the body and mind through the practices of breathing. Because in between the body and mind, our breath is a called bridge. Okay, coming to the mantra chanting. Om Kesavaya Swaha, Om Madhavaya Swaha, Om Narayanaya Swaha, Om Adya Samadhi Tatpala Siddhyardham Asana Purvakam Pranayama Din Karishye, Om Sandha Sandha Sandhi. And after this chanting, our next practice will be our Kriya Abhyas, cleaning technique. What we call Kapala Bhati. Kapala Bhati is a Kriya, frontal brain cleaning technique. Also, it is a good practice to balance the, especially phlegm related disorders. Kapa Dosha Visoshini. The nickname of the Kapala Bhati is Kapa Dosha Visoshini, nullifier, the nullifier of the Kapala Bhati, called as Vastrava Loha Karasya Resha Purav Sasam Bhramav Kapala Bhatir Vikyata Kapa Dosha Visoshini. And coming to next exercise, we are doing Nadi Shuddhi or Nadi Sodhana Pranayam. In traditional text called Hatiyo Pradipka, it has given the fine answer regarding this practice. One should always start from the left nostril and release the air with the right nostril, and start lifting the air with the right nostril and create the same alternative nostril, breathe out. Here it is saying that Baddha Padmasano Yogi Pranam Chandrena Purayet Dharayatva Yadha Sekti Voya Suryena Rechayet. प्राणं सूर्येन च कृष्या पूरये दधुरप्सनैः विधिवत् कुम्भकः कृत्वा पुनश्चन्द्रेण रेचयेत्. मीन्स वन शुड ऑलवेज अवेयर ऑफ दैट ब्रीथ इन ब्रीथ आउट्स मस्ट बी वेरी स्लो टू क्रिएट दैट हैबिट. दिस प्राणायाम्स दिस बंधास एंड मुद्रास एक्चुअली ऑरिजिनेटेड. So like in our regular activities, regular affairs also, like we have to be always care about the breath. We have to be very slow in the breathings and breathe outs. Especially if you are totally care about the breath voluntarily in your regular activities. So the people, for them, so no matter of stress, for them no matter of fear, for them no matter of depression or no matter of other phobias and fears. Okay, coming to practices, very simple and effective practices. First important thing is keep your position straight. Be very confident and be very confident while doing this kind of practices. Especially Kapalabhati, coming to Kapalabhati, when you have heart ailments or blood pressure issues or any issues in the head called throwing sensations or vertigo or ear problems, immediately do not attempt this practices. Better to choose an advice from the people who already knows these practices. Keep your position straight. And Kapalabhati is a voluntary sharp exhalation, slow inhalation. And now starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then very slowly, long, deep inhalation and exhalation. So please remember, in these pranayamas, in this kriya also, for our online participants, I'm not doing very slow as well as I'm not doing very fast, just I'm fixing this timetable in a medium way. Keep your position straight for the second spell towards the 20th count and starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again deep slow inhalation and completely deep slow exhalation towards 30, last spell. Again starting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again deep slow inhalation, then completely deep slow breathe out. So after Kapalabhati or any kriya abhyas, again it is better to create some small gap. Like if you are really wants to drink water, you can drink a sip of water also. Right, coming to the actually pranayam, like first we are starting with the left nostril. So that open your right hand, last two fingers and right hand thumb, turn them towards the face. Obviously your right nostril will receive right thumb, left nostril will receive last two fingers of the right hand. So here close your right nostril to functioning with the left nostril for inhalation. And small break, then after that close your left nostril, completely breathe out with the right nostril, but very slow. Again inhalation with the right nostril and completely slowly breathe out with the alternative nostril. Last two rounds inhalation with the left nostril and completely slowly breathe out with the alternative nostril. And right nostril inhalation and very slowly completely left nostril breathe out, then slowly keep your hand down. And after finishing your pranayama practices, if you know about the dharana practices, you can directly go to the dharana practices, or you can choose any of the good practices from the trataka abhyasas, concentration practices. Then soon after finishing those, so you can choose some more time to give relaxation to the body and mind through yoga nidra or through power nap. And after finishing your total yoga workout, so like create 15 minutes time to take bath, further 5 minutes time to take breakfast. That timing also depend on the how we are doing, in what way we are doing also very important. So in the afternoon, before your lunch hour, see all the possibilities to do power nap or yoga nidra. So it for that, actually we not really required bed or any flat items. We can sit on the in the chair and we can do these practices, yoga nidra and power nap. So in the evening, after finishing your houseworks or office work, sports work, games work, garden works, or before dinner time, so choose at least 15 minutes to 20 minutes or further to half an hour time also to do any kind of physical exercises, including yoga practices, and choose back bending, simple back bending exercise and simple inverted postures also, along with the breathe in and breathe outs. But please remember, during your diet timings, do not blindly depend on the carbohydrates, or do not blindly depend on the red meat or any uneven meat which is not really suitable, especially in the evenings or nights. But please take advice also about those diets, so what to do, what not to do. When you are going to eating in the evening, so curds and buttermilk and milk products are not really suggestible. Red meats also not really suggestible. So we have some of the preparations in the diet, right time and the right diet and with the right combinations. That's also very important to create healthy. And tomorrow when we are meeting here at the same time, same topic in the Ayurveda, we will see some more topics for the same skin tags, and in the yoga also we will see some more other good exercises. So thanking you all to giving me this wonderful opportunity. Stay away from the bad habits and do yoga also. Thanking you all.